terrific artist Smpl here, who was able to bless me with having an interview with Smpl, and I'm just here to hear his story. Born on the far side of Eastern Shore. When did you start? His mom and his dad split up at a time, and then you were moved to where?
I moved to, it's called, are you ready to go?
It's a collective enjoyment.
You wish you had a night?
It's like just urban kids, basically.
Who did this?
You got your tattoos. You can close your eyes. Nobody got respect. Nobody got respect.
Like you high talent.
I'd rather go through trials and tribulations and learn from everything than be in the desk working. I am a hardcore X fan. How did that hit you? I didn't even see social media.
Yeah,
you felt it when it happened.
Bro, that was literally me because everything happened.
I was like, that day, I remember exactly where I was. I was literally at a Bible study. And literally, out of nowhere, I was like, I gotta take a second. They were like, what's wrong? I was like, I don't know. I need a second to be alone. And then I checked social media, and it's I was live streaming at the time.
Yes, sir.
We got one more time.
Last night, are you high?
He asked all the right questions, but what's wrong?
And I was like, I don't know. I was just like felt really shitty. And then I like clicked on my Twitter feed, while I was like not fucking doing something.
I just want to know right
just,
now.
Like, started
bawling. Do y'all feel the same way I do?
Live to fucking 1,000 people just bawling my eyes out. I was like,
y'all realize?
I gotta reassess myself. I'm sorry, but he was like, I love you guys out there, but I need to take a time for myself.
I don't really.
Does anybody feel all one here today at ESC Fest?
They really don't.
I was like, everyone had these like conspiracy theories, blah blah blah. He's still alive. I was like, no, I don't feel him.
I don't feel him here. I don't feel him. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. His energy, his zen, it's not here.
It's not here.
Because when I felt whole. I felt whole, I'd say. He was here, but when I don't feel that.
I don't want to let you on to myself. I let into myself too much, or I let you really think that I believe nobody's going to fucking listen to me.
No, sir.
But if I give you a lot of words to you, then you lock your fucking mind, then you're going to be a fucking bullshit. All of the people in the scene who are starting to really do something since you died.
Got here to be with your friends and you're not
of nowhere, you were backstage. That's going there.
So I was sitting there.
Yes, sir.
I got a lot of requests to play this song of mine called Beautiful Problems. For somebody's friend who passed away recently, and this is their favorite song. So this is your request to see you sing it.
Right after 8, like, I was super, super big into fucking the gym, obviously, because I'm white and I'm from Detroit. So that's just
what I'm saying.
I don't give a fuck, like, I'm always going
to
say
that. Now let's give love to the front real quick. Give me a sound.
I don't fucking hide behind home. I don't want to be a person.
Come on.
No. I'll never be a person.
No. Because I'm a person.
Yeah, you're your own. You're your own.
So I was obviously super big.
Sing it with me right now.
And then, probably about 9, 10,
fucking love right there, bro.
I came.
Anyone else out there need anything right now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah? Someone over there?
I don't even know. But I came here when I was 16.
Come on.
So that was like
help 5, 6 years.
Yeah.
All good?
Basically just fucking snuck in this bitch. It's had a fucking amazing time.
But this side of the crowd was
way different than how it is.
Anyone
now.
Else
here? So
thanks
unreal.
A lot. Thanks a lot.
Like, no
everybody.
Fuck about it. It was like, I swear it was like there was kids in this bitch. Like straight kids. I was 16 years old just chilling.
Just chilling, enjoying music.
Yeah. Anyone need anything else?
Like,
is
but now, so now looking
I'm
at yourself,
middle,
you was on stage
with MGK.
With
you can get paused like you can resume right now. What's it look like?
Dead ass
how,
serious.
Okay, yeah, I'm yeah, sorry to like divert. How did you feel?
I walked up to the back in VIP and looked at the TV and I said, and I was literally on the
stage. I said, I'm looking for a girl. She got a piercing and she even got some. And you can bring her on her because that's cool. No strings attached. And when you go back, we keep it chill. Yeah,